Hello viewers, in this part of program, that is soils of Uttar Pradesh, I would tell you about the soils of Uttar Pradesh. As we know that Uttar Pradesh is situated in the foothills of Himalayas along the river Ganga and its tributaries. So most of the soils of Uttar Pradesh have been developed on the alluviums brought out by these different rivers from the Himalayas. So let us start with the geography of Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh is situated between 23 degree 52 minute to 30 degree 25 minute north latitude and 77 degree 4 minute to 84 degree 39 minute east longitude. The total geographical area of Uttar Pradesh is 29.4 million hectare. That is 7.33% of the country. The east boundary of the state touches the Bihar. The south boundary touches with Madhya Pradesh. The southwest with Rajasthan. In west there is Delhi and Haryana. And in northwest there is Uttarakhand and Himachal Pradesh. Physiographically, Uttar Pradesh have been divided into three regions. The Himalaya region have been divided into three parts. First is sub-Himalayas or Shivalika zones. It is 300 to 600 meter high above mean sea level. The second one is lesser Himalayas. The height is 2000 to 3000 meter above mean sea level. The third one is greater Himalayas or Himadri. The height is 7000 to 9000 meter above mean sea level. The second region is the Gangetic Plains. It is between Himalayas in north and Vindhyan Hills and plateaus in the south. It is deep and almost level lands is sloping gently from northwest to southeast. The third is Vindhyan Hills and plateau. It is situated in the south of Gangetic Plain. It is the foreland of Deccan Peninsula. It has been divided into four regions. First is Bundelkhand Plateau, second one is Vindhyan Hills, third is Vindhyan Scrapland, and the fourth is Vindhyan Plateau. So, physiographically, Uttar Pradesh have been divided in three parts, that is Himalaya region, Gangetic region, and the Vindhyan Plateaus and Hill region. Now comes to climate of Uttar Pradesh. In Himalayan region, there is humid temperate climate is there. Summers are short and cool, winters have frost and snow at higher altitude. The rainfall in this Himalayan region is 1400 to 2000 millimeter per year. In Gangetic Plain, the climate is semi-arid to sub-humid. Summers are very hot, winters are cool and dry. The rainfall is 650 millimeter in southwest Agra and Mathura districts and 1000 millimeter in east and southeast part of the state. In Vindhyan Hills and Plateau, the climate is subtropical and the rainfall is in between 1000 and 1200 millimeter. The rainfall in the state is mostly monsoonal type. This is agroclimatic zones in UP. UP have been divided into 9 agroclimatic zones. These are Tarai, Western Plain, Central Western Semi-Arid Plain, Mid Western Plain, Central Plain, Bundelkhand, Northeastern Plain, Eastern Plain, and Vindhyan region. Now comes to the soils. Soils of the Uttar Pradesh have been classified in 7 broad soil groups. First is hill soils, second Bhabar soils, third Tarai soils, fourth alluvial soils, fifth Vindhyan soils, sixth Bundelkhand soils, and seventh Aravalli soils. So now we would study one by one all these types of soils. First is hill soil. Hill soil is 14% of total area in the northmost part of the state. Hill soils developed from biotite, schist, and phyletic material under cool and moist climate. Soil associations found in hill soils are red loams, brown forest, podzolic and meadow soils. The great groups found in hill soils are fragudalfs, haplodalfs, haplostalfs, distrocrafts, eutrocrafts, haplumbrafts, pale humults, astothents and argeodols. The colors of hill soils are brown to grayish brown and dark gray. The reaction in hill soils is neutral to slightly acidic, means they are moderately acidic at higher elevations where leaching of bases with percolating rain water is a common occurrence. Hill soils are dark brown or black in color. This soil is relatively fertile, especially in the lower altitudes. It has a high humus or organic carbon content. These are found in the hill slopes of northern India. It is generally a dark brown to black color. The soil is formed by the deposition of organic matter from the forest. So in these hill soils, there are tree plantation found and these soils are fertile soils. The next one is Babar soils. A narrow belt of alluvial soil termed as Babar, immediately adjoining the outer spurs of Himalayas running from west to east in the foothill regions, is Babar soil. The area of Babar soil in the state is 2%. They developed from the mechanically transported alluviums from the adjoining Shivalik and Himalayan ranges, comprising of micaceous sandstones and conglomerates interstratified with boulders along with purple shales and clays. The great groups found in Babar soils are astothcrafts, astothents and haplostalfs. They are coarse gravelly to fine silty, calcareous and rich in plant nutrients. The color of Babar soils is dark gray. The next one is Tarai soils. Tarai means moist and wet area. These are the alluvial soils. There is narrow belt to the south of Babar soils in the valleys of sub-mountain regions of Uttar Pradesh. Area of Tarai soil is 5.7% of the total area in UP. It is divided into two distinct parts. First is Northwest Tarai, extending from Dehradun to Lakhimpur Kheri, and the second one is Northeast Tarai, extending from Bahraich to Deoria district. Soil associations found in Northwest Tarai are Tarai sand, Tarai loams, that is highly calcareous, Tarai loams, slightly calcareous, Tarai loams, non-calcareous, Tarai clay loam, highly calcareous, and Tarai clay loam, non-calcareous. The great groups found in this Northwest Tarai are haplodols, haplicols, astothents, and astothcrafts. Soil associations in Northeast Tarai are Gandak recent alluviums, calcium soils with large reserves of soft lime, second Gandak flat, leached calcium soils with a layer of calcium carbonate accumulation, and the Gandak uplands. These are the degraded calcium soils. The color of this Northeast Tarai soils gray to dark gray. The texture is sand to clay loam. Organic matter is high and the water table is high. Soil remains saturated or fairly moist during the major part of the year. So these Tarai soils are fertile soils and they contribute a major share of food grain production in the country. The next one is the alluvial soils. The area of alluvial soil in the state is 61.8% of the total area of the state. Alluvial soils of the state have been divided into two regions. First is gangetic alluvial soils, means alluvial material deposited by Ganga and its tributaries is derived from the soft dolomite rocks of Himalayas, excessively deep, coarse sands to fine clays. They are neutral to moderately alkaline and calcareous, especially at lower depths. The second one is Yamuna alluvial soils. Alluvial material deposited by Yamuna and its tributaries is derived from basaltic rocks of central Indian hills. They are dark to very dark gray, fine texture, calcareous, showing swelling and shrinking on wetting and drying. The general slope of the Gangetic Plain being from northwest to southeast, the finer fraction increases from western to eastern parts of the state due to gravimetric assorting of soil particles during the course of their deposition. The grade groups found in alluvial soils are haplodolphs, paludolphs, haplostalphs, ochroaquils, eutocrepts, astocrepts, astifluents, astorthents, and calciorthents. The nutrient level in alluvial soil is that they are poor in phosphorus and nitrogen and oxygen. So these alluvial soils are poor in fertility but having high in potassium. These alluvial soils also contribute a major portion of food grain production in the state. Alluvial soils are very suitable for plant growth. This is the most common soil type in India. There are two types of alluvial soils. First is Khaddar soil and the second one is Bangar soil. Khaddar soil is new alluvial soil and is more fertile than Bangar soil or old alluvial soils. It is generally light to dark in color. Alluvial is soil also rich in potassium and has high fertility. Alluvial soil is best suitable for growing crops such as paddy, sugarcane and plantation. The next one is Bundelkhand soil. The area of Bundelkhand soil in the state is 10.9%. They developed from Vindhyan rocks abounding in gneiss and granites of the Deccan trap with highly ferruginous beds and often soft limestone. Bundelkhand soils have been divided into two broad groups. First is red soils and the second is black soils. Soil associations found in Bundelkhand soils are first Bundelkhand coarse-grained reddish-brown soils, also known as rakar. Second, Bundelkhand coarse-grained grey to grayish-brown soils known as parwa. Third is Bundelkhand clay loam black soils known as kabar. And the fourth one is Bundelkhand fine clay black soils known as mar. These are the red soils, rakar and parwa, found in the order astisols, alfisols and inceptisols. The grade groups are palustrates, chromostrates and astocrepts. Rakar soils are coarse-grained, slightly acidic, shallow, excessively permeable, occupying higher elevations. Parwa soils are alluvial, mildly alkaline, very deep with free calcium carbonate accumulation at lower depths. Black soils, mar and kabar, are very deep, confined to low-lying landscapes, having fine texture, shrinkage and swelling on wetting and drying. The next one is Vindhyan soils. The area of Vindhyan soil in the state is 5.1% of the total area, situated in the south of Ganga in the southeast corner of Uttar Pradesh. Vindhyan soils have developed on Vindhyan rocks comprising Vindhyan and Kaimud sandstones, shales, mixed conglomerates, calcareous and hematitic slates, schist, gneiss, carboniferous rocks and to some extent the limestones. Soil associations found in Vindhyan soils are Vindhyan type 1 to 5. First, Vindhyan type 1 and second. These are the upland soils, brown to dark brown, coarse textured, shallow to moderately deep, slightly acidic and excessively drained soils. The grade groups found in Vindhyan soils are haplostalts, rhodostalts and rhodostalphs. The second is Vindhyan type 3. These are the flat soils, very deep, yellowish grey, loam to clay loam, restricted drainage is there. The third is Vindhyan type 4 and 5th. These are lowland soils, fine textured, grey to dark grey, poorly drained soils underlain by a calcic horizon. The grade groups of Vindhyan type 3, 4 and 5 are haplostalphs, ochroaquils, eutocrepts, astocrepts and astifluents. The next one is Aravalli soils. Area of Aravalli soils in the state is 0.21%. It is situated in the southwest corner of Agra district. Aravalli soils developed from various formations of Vindhyan sandstones, including Kaimur group as the lowest and Bandar group as the highest member in the outer spurs of central India hills of Bharatpur and Dholpur. So most of the soils of Uttar Pradesh have developed on the alluvium brought out by the rivers from Himalayan regions, and they are suitable for growing every type of crops in the region and they contribute a major share of food grain production in the country. Now comes to the problem soils. Besides the above soil groups, some problem soils are also found in the state. The problem soils include first, saline and alkali soils, second, eroded soils, third, shallow and excessively permeable soils, and the fourth, waterlogged soils. Status of problematic soils in the state. Arable degraded land are found in 11.3 lakh hectare. Non-arable degraded land are found in 7.21 lakh hectare. Ravines land found in 3.58 lakh hectare. Sodic land found in 5.33 lakh hectare. Waterlogged soil found in 5.13 lakh hectare. Dyara and Khaddar soil found in 13.28 lakh hectare. And total problematic soil in the state is 45.83 lakh hectare. First is saline and alkali soils. The area of saline and alkali soil in the state is 1.28 million hectare. Now distribution of these soils in the state. Alkali soils are found in Manipur, Aligarh, Etah, Farukhabad, Etawah, Auria, Kanpur, Unnao, Fatehpur, Allahabad, Raebareli, Lucknow, Pratapgarh and Hardoi districts. Saline soils found in Agra and Mathura districts. Degraded alkali soils found in Ajamgarh, Lucknow, Hardoi districts. Some small low-lying pockets developed under continued rice cultivation formed the degraded alkali soils. These saline soils have electrical conductivity more than 4 decisiemen per meter, pH less than 8.5, and the exchangeable sodium percentage is less than 15. The permeability is more or equal to the normal soil. The plant growth is affected in saline soil due to the osmotic effect of excess salts and due to the nutritional imbalance. So the saline soils, which have a white crustacean of salts on the surface, have the problem of excess salts in the soil solution. The growth of plant is affected due to the excess salt, means due to the osmotic effect in the root zone. If the concentration of soil solution is higher compared to the concentration of the root cell sap, then water start coming out of the root cell and causes the physiological dryness. Though water is available there, but due to the high concentration of salt in the soil solution, plant are not able to draw the water from the soil, and there is physiological dryness in the crops. The next is alkali soils. Alkali soil have electrical conductivity less than 4 decisiemen per meter, pH more than 8.5, exchangeable sodium percentage more than 15. The permeability is less than normal soils. The plant growth is affected due to the poor physical properties of soil and toxicity of sodium and carbonate ions in the soil. The next is eroded soils. The soil erosion in the state is in 5.5 million hectare. Glacial erosion is in 0.15 million hectare, sheet and drill erosion in 2.94 million hectare, gullies in 1.53 million hectare, and wind erosion in 0.9 million hectare. The problem of erosion and mass soil washing, such as landslides, rock falls, and soil creep, occur in the hilly tracts of Kumaon and Garhwal. Wind erosion occurs in the southwest part of Agra and Mathura, bordering Rajasthan. Ravine is a major problem along the banks of Yamuna, Chambal and Betwa districts. The next is waterlogged soils. Waterlogged soils are situated in the eastern parts of Uttar Pradesh. They are in the lower basins of the Ganga, below the confluence of Yamuna and Ganga, Allahabad, Mirzapur, Varanasi, Ghazipur, Balia presents the typical hydromorphic soils of the state. There is high water table and very slow surface drainage pose a serious problem in major parts of Uttar Pradesh. In some parts, problem has been accentuated by canal irrigation. The tarai and alluvial soils of the state are fertile soils and contribute a major share of food grain production in the country. The problematic soils, particularly saline and alkali soil, are also in a considerable area in the state, due to the poor irrigation management practices in the canal command areas. The eroded soils are also in the large parts of the state due to the slopy terrain and due to the floods in the rivers every year, posing a serious problem to the soil conservation program in the state.